Just the weekend before I was set to start my middle school, my father asked me to squirt this tube of toothpaste on a plate. He then asked me to put this toothpaste back inside the tube. I was confused. I told him, "Papa, I can't put it back inside. The toothpaste will never be like it was before." He told me, "Aditi, you will remember this tube of toothpaste for the rest of your life now. Because just like this toothpaste squirted out, once words leave your mouth, you cannot take them back. Good evening, Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and guests.
Good evening.
Good evening.
As I grew older, I realized the weight one's words carry, the power the words carry to encourage, inspire and love others, and also the power the same words carry to hurt, demean or wound others. Do any of you remember the last day at your school? Wasn't it a very nostalgic and special feeling? I also remember my last day at school when my friends gifted me a video they had created for me. The video had memories recorded all throughout school, but most importantly, they recorded words of appraisal for me. They told me they would miss me, and in the end, they said, "We are always there for you, Aditi." It's those words recorded in the video which I still remember, because it made me feel happy, it made me feel loved, it made me feel special. Whenever I feel I'm not good enough, whenever I need some self-motivation in life, I always look back to that video, because that video always helps me to push myself forward and help me achieve what I need to do. It is then I remembered what my father had taught me back in middle school. The power of words, the power words carry to inspire, encourage and love others. And with the same words, you can also destroy someone's life. The choice is absolutely yours. One fine day, I had a really, really bad day at work. I came back home exhausted, exasperated and tired. I sat in my room thinking, reflecting on my day, when suddenly my sister barged inside my room. She said, "Didi, can you please go down? The cake has come, the guests are coming." Before she could complete what she had to say, I said, "Anushka, don't you see I'm so tired? Just get out and leave me alone." She closed the room and left me alone. After about half an hour, the guests did arrive. The guests were carrying a cake and some presents. It then struck me that they had come to celebrate my grandparents' anniversary, which I had forgotten about. And I felt extremely guilty and shameful that time for not giving my sister one chance to speak and complete what she had to say to me. I felt extremely shameful of myself for not pausing that one moment. That day, the guests did arrive. My grandparents did have a very fancy celebration of their anniversary. I did apologize to my sister, but I could not take away the guilt I had of shouting at my sister and not letting her speak. Have you ever felt a similar guilt in your life? Have you ever fired an SMS or called someone saying all sorts of noble things, but the tone of communication was full of venom? In our word-centered society, we always bombard each other with words from all directions at all hours of our lives. But it is very important to see how we speak and what we say. It is almost always a prescription for disaster to allow the mouth to speak when in a fit of rage, like I did when I spoke to my sister. But it is very important to take a pause that time. I clearly remember those incidents, and today when I reflect on them, I think, had I paused one more time? Our lives here are very very, very short. And in the end, our family and friends only remember the conversations we had and the moments we spent together. So it is very important that you use the power of words, which all of you are carrying all the time, very wisely, because you have the power of changing someone's life. So next time you speak to someone, make sure you use your words wisely, because just like the toothpaste squirted out, you cannot take them back. And like Mukesh says, ek din bik jayega maati ke mool, jag mein reh jayenge pyare tere bol. That means a day will come when we all will not be there, but what will remain is only the words you said. Only the words you said. Madam Toastmaster,